While you were flying, a high priority message came in from the Admiral.
Let's take a look.
Colonel, I've been getting strange, troubling reports out of the failure system. Now, we've been losing ships, yet there seems to be no enemy presence. I'm ordering Intrepid to look into this. Alias is absolutely vital to our efforts. The major source of fuel, as well as a strategic location. Lose Palius, and our cause cannot prevail.
You heard the man.
Yes, I did, sir. Inputting coordinates now.
Systems.
We're sitting ducks. Reverse course.
Right away, sir.
Maybe we can pull out of range of whatever's causing this.
Oh, this is great. Now we gotta fly blind? Groping around like some pathetic sandworm on Isis 7?
You still have eyes, you know. Welcome to Palius.
Can I get my money back for this tour?
Edge of this jamming black hole, sir, but I'd have to say we're still only partially sighted.
Well, then we got no choice. We go out on a search and destroy.
Hey, that's suicide. There could be a whole fleet waiting out there for us. We wouldn't know it.
No radar, no shields.
Without any guidance systems, the dumb flyers are going to be the only firecrackers worth taking.
Okay, something's thrown a blanket on the system. Let's go out, find it, and put it out of business. Move!
Since the shields ain't working, me and my people have been beefing up everyone's armor. If you know what's good for you, you'll shift your shield power to the engines. You're gonna carry a lot of strain with all that extra weight.
Tell us where the jammy's coming from.
Who are you working for?
What kind of interference is it?
How many ships are there?
Come on, talk.
How many ships are there?
I don't have to tell you a damn thing.
No, talk to me.
Take it easy, Hawk. Come on.
So you're with them now. You did me a good turn once.
Yeah? Why the sudden change in attitude?
I owe him one.
Hey, let's everybody relax. Nobody's gonna hurt you. Here.
Listen, I was just flying for these guys because they paid me anyway. Ain't like the old days, when you had a cause.
Are you so sure? There's people dying out there that don't deserve it. Why don't you tell us what you know?
You get me home?
You've got my word.
You're looking for a cap ship. They re-outfitted it, so you'd hardly recognize it was ever one of ours. It moves around every 6 hours. I'll plot it for you on a nav map. Has to uncloak when it fires its engines. Otherwise, it lays low. It's packed full of gadgets that do the jamming. I don't even know what it's doing here. It's an evil old thing. It's no damn honor in just poking someone in the eye.
Listen, you got a place here. If you want it.
No. My flying days are over. Next time, won't be an ejection pod, it'll be a coffin. I'd like to postpone that for a while, if you don't mind.
That'll get you cleaned up. Something to eat. Come on.
It's okay.
Come on.
Here they come now. Everybody here? All right, Lieutenant.
Sir, we received this in the past hour.
Colonel, I hope this reaches you. I've had to halt all our traffic through Palius, and it is seriously hampering Border World's efforts. You're our last hope of regaining the system and its resources. do about it. Our endeavors are doomed. Good luck.
Now that we know what our target is and its navigation schedule, I think our chances are pretty good. Now, this jamming cap ship has to be destroyed, and there's only one way to do that.
Yeah, with just the dumpfires? Our aim's gonna have to be perfect.
Some of us know how to aim, Maniac. We don't just rely on dumb luck. Let's do it, people.
Another for the Maniac!
Mission complete.
Two visual targets dead ahead.
Someone's in a mighty big hurry to make tracks. Might be interesting to find out just who it is.
The long-range comm system is still a little shaky, sir, but give me a minute, and I will raise the colonel for you.
They don't pay me to defer decisions, Lieutenant. Colonel's cleared a path. Someone's got to walk down it.
What's wrong? Look like you've just seen a ghost.
You'll never believe who Decker just hauled on board.
Decker? What the hell are you talking about?
Just go see. Go see down in the hold, the storage room. I think that's where Decker stowed him.
Begin to convey my despair on hearing of your defection.
We're not officially at war, Admiral. Think of it as a re-enlistment.
We weren't officially at war with the Kilrathi either, but there were two sides, and defection was the only possible movement between them. You symbolized everything Confed stands for. Surely you can understand why I'm so utterly astonished by your actions. Just because we operate in the void of space, is loyalty equally weightless?
I don't think so. It's the Confederation who's forgotten about loyalty, sir. It's Confed forces behind all of this. Someone who wants to start an all-out war.
Yes. I believe you're right. I think your perceptions of things, for the most part, is absolutely true. That's why you find me here. Dog soldiers, you might call them. Renegades within Confed who sow disorder.
Yes. There's a highly skilled pilot involved. His call sign is Seether.
Well, I'm not surprised you two have run into him. The fact that you find me out here tells you how delicate these investigations have become. Finding somebody I can trust has not been easy. During the war, there were many black ops, secret efforts to finish off the Kilrathi. Many of them so highly classified that I'm just learning of them now myself.
GE program?
Genetic enhancement,
yes.
Some idiot thought they could breed the perfect warrior.
Is Seether a product of that program?
I wouldn't know. That was shut down well before I got wind of it. At any rate, I thought I might track him down here. We were getting the same reports about the jamming, but I can assure you, it was not authorized by Confed HQ. And that hidden installation was empty by the time I got there. You wouldn't happen to know where this seether is now, would you?
No, I... Ah.
Time's running out for us, Colonel.
Us?
You and I. Both want to prevent war, not wage it. There's still a place for you in the Confederation. We're on the same side, Colonel. Always have been.
I'm not sure we are, Admiral. I'm not sure I recognize what CONFED stands for anymore. But these people, aboard this ship, I know them. I trust them. If there's gonna be a war, this is the side I'm on.
Am I your prisoner of war then, Colonel?
Like I said, we're not officially at war. You'll be released. And I hope you're right, Admiral. I hope we are on the same side.
Decker.
What? Well, then what the hell have I been doing out there risking my neck? Let me tell you something, boss. Anybody with CONFED is the enemy.
Let me tell you something. One, you had no orders to go out on your own. And two, it's my decision as to who's a prisoner of war here, declared or otherwise.
I just think it's mighty suspicious that your buddy the Admiral is trying to make a run for it.
You have any idea what kind of hell would rain down on us if we imprisoned a CONFED Admiral?
Well, maybe you're right. Just mark my words, I think you're gonna second-guess yourself on this somewhere down the line.
Is that a prediction or a threat?
Just an observation. From a grunt who's had his head dented too many times anyway.
This just came in, sir.
Colonel. We're undertaking fleet actions in two different systems. At Cersei, we'll be assisting the legitimate Border Worlds government in a fierce civil war instigated by mercenaries. Now, we believe these mercs are backed by elements within CONFED. And thousands of civilians are being killed. Now, the other operation is in Spiridon, another Border Worlds territory, where a CONFED shipyard has geared up in anticipation of war. Now it appears vulnerable, and you know how badly our forces need equipment. Well, I wish you could be in both places at once, but since that isn't possible, I'm leaving the choice in your capable hands.
You heard what he said. Innocent people are being wiped out in Cersei. The choice is clear.
It's not as clear as all that, Colonel. We can't win battles anywhere if we don't have the weapons. That shipyard could be the answer to our prayers.
Nobody here signed up for a suicide mission. I can't send people into battle unless I've done everything I can to give them a fighting chance. We're heading for Spiridon. Set a course.
Aye, sir.
Thank you. never met a flyboy who could hump a 60-kilo war pack across 30 clicks of double-gravity terrain. You guys are soft where it counts.
Oh, we're soft. Let me tell you about soft. I took a Marine on a little joyride once. I jammed the stick, took the skyscraper climb, cut the juice, reignited halfway through our fall, I flipped into a bank and roll, little 360, I was just warming up. I look in the back, the grunt has tossed his cookies, passed out. Just from taking a quarter G to five Gs. The rejects at Space Academy, they make Marines.
What a crock. You guys go for the cockpit because you can't cut it up close and personal.
Up close and personal, I hear Marines have no staying power.
Marines go all night long and then some.
Not with their sabers extended.
I'll show you some staying power.
You want a piece of me?
I'll kick your ass.
Come on.
Hey. Look, that first punch is gonna buy you a trip to the brig, mister.
I'm sick of this guy running off with a mouth. You need a dose of Decker medicine.
Look, if it's that easy to get your goat, Decker, how are you gonna keep your cool in the field?
Now, you space jocks, I'll stick together, that's right. I'll remember that the next time I'm out there risking my neck for you guys.
I could have taken him. What? Come on!
Hey, now, will you please?
Hey! That's some good news, kid.
I can always use some of that.
Your Carathi pals are pretty helpful with my cloaker gadget.
You got it working?
Yeah, the cat showed me how to get some extra charges out of the crystal that runs it. Problem is, I only got one of them crystals left, so you can forget about having a wingman along. Flying next to a guy who ain't cloaked kind of defeats the purpose anyway, right? And, of course, the crystal's still gonna burn out sooner or later. Hopefully later. Personally, I'd like to see us raiding those mines where they dig up those crystals. But they're pretty deep in Confed territory. Anyways, care to run with it, kid?
Make me invisible, Pliers.
Your wish is my command, kid.
Lieutenant? Yeah, everybody here? All right.
Colonel, I'm here in spirit on commanding a fleet action. As you know, we're here to raid a shipyard. But there are several other targets we'd like to acquire first.
Well, I'm ready to review them, Admiral.
Now, this is a testing site with an asteroid belt where Confed shakes down their newly built fighters. We'd love to confiscate a few. Second, the ring planet in this system is orbited by a weapons manufacturing plant. Another prime target. And finally, we've zeroed in on a carrier, poorly guarded, undergoing some ad hoc repairs near the outermost planet. Now, I'm downloading mission specifics and a pre-recorded briefing for each operation. I'll leave you to size up the tactical situation, Colonel, and make the decision on how to proceed. Good luck. This asteroid belt hides a testing ground for Confed's newly built fighters. Now, one hitch is that they've got an electronic moat around the site, including a sophisticated radar device, which should probably be your initial target, if you can sneak up on it. Now, once you've disabled the fighters, we'll send in a cap ship from our fleet to pick them up.
We track on their radar. They're going to have all kinds of reinforcements to check us. Sure we fly invisible.
Our leech gun should disable these fighters.
All right, people, let's go.
Your friend's really pissing me off.
Let me take a wild guess. Maniac.
You know, he doesn't quite have the rep you have. And as far as I'm concerned, he really hasn't proven himself. He ought to have a little more humility and learn how to fly support instead of going off and doing his own thing.
Well, you want me to talk to him?
Yeah, I think that'd be a little better than me hauling his ass over the coals.
Well... That would certainly get his attention. But let me see what I can do.
The weapons plant orbiting this ring planet has quite a little security blanket. Now they're sure to see you coming on their radar. But if you manage to clear a path, Your Marines can be shuttled in to take control of it. Then we'll be able to collect some of the equipment that our forces urgently need.
All right, let's go to work.
Anyway, I fire a couple missiles way over their heads, right? So they think I just can't aim. Then, when I got my last heat seeker, bam! They never know what hit them. They think it's an accident.
Yeah, probably because it was an accident.
Excuse me, the boy's trying to learn ways to break out of the pack, you know, to find an edge. Now, he can learn to fly with shields up like Grandma by listening to you, or he can push the envelope a little bit.
The only envelope you've ever pushed is the one addressed to common sense.
Well, he does have quite a kill score, sir.
Maniac leads a charmed life. There's one on every ship, but only one. Relying on luck like he does is a poor way to reach old age.
There you have it, kid. You can reach old age, like a certain someone we know, and maybe get yourself a gold watch. Or you could fly the stick with little style, huh? Little tude. Make a name for yourself. Tough call.
But the choice is yours, Cat Scratch. You want your name on a gold watch? Or a coffin?
You gonna finish that?
No.
Really? What is that stuff?
I don't know.
Oh, thanks. Everybody here? All right.
Colonel, for a long time we've been trying to suss out an equipment supply line we believe might skirt the edges of this system. Well, it looks like we've gotten a break. A huge convoy is coming through the line. Now, I'm pulling you off the sorties we discussed earlier, and I'm assigning you to the advanced forces raiding this convoy. Now, we'd like to insert a few Marines aboard the largest of the capital ships so they can take control of it.
Sounds like we ought to be getting hazard pay for this.
They're working for the wrong side if you're looking for bonuses.
Decker, we'll use the insertion pods to deliver you and your men. They'll think it's just another missile.
Don't forget about picking us up, boss.
Now, shops from our fleet will shuttle in larger forces so we can complete the raid. You're the shock troops. We go or we don't go on your say-so. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Oh, one other thing. We're picking up some very odd redshift signals from a small artificial satellite circling the fourth planet. Now, we'd like to pluck this thing out of its orbit, take a closer look at it. Good luck.
All right, who wants the tractor and that satellite?
I'll volunteer for that one, sir.
Any other takers? All right, Cat Scratch, looks like the milk run's yours. Let's go, people.
Sir, Cat Scratch is in big trouble. He's recovered the satellite, but the enemy's tracked him down and leached his craft. He's a sitting duck, sir.
All right, what's it gonna be, boss? It's getting pretty damn hot and cramped in here. Mission objectives 86th.
You can't let the kid die. We're going after him.
Need clearance.
You're cleared, sir, and thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Sorry, sir.
I just want to know how the hell you got in that predicament. It was supposed to be a milk run.
I guess it got a little too clever, sir. I fired off a couple missiles as decoys like Maniac was talking about. Only I missed when it really counted, sir.
I should have known. If I ever hear you handing out advice again, I will personally put a big red bullseye on your back and declare it open season.
Well,
Let me tell you something. There's a lower asshole tolerance around here, old buddy. You better get with the program.
I'll check with you later.
You know, that stunt cost us. Cost the border worlds quite a lot.
I'm really sorry, sir.
We weren't so desperate for pilots. I'd ground you in a minute, but consider yourself on probation. For the rest of the decade.
Finally feels like we're on the right track, kid. How'd you like a little extra punch on board for your next mission?
I'm listening.
Well, we can bang the metal a couple places, open up a little more space, maybe squeeze in another missile or two. Might take a couple clicks off the old Speedo, but it sure'd be nice to have an ace in the hole, huh? What do you say?
I like the sound of that.
Good.
Hours.
46? It's only been 20 for me.
What?
Since I slept.
No, I'm talking about how long it's been since Captain Eisen left. He hasn't sent a trance, has he?
Not a glitch. He makes it.
Boy, for our sake, I hope he does too. Get the feeling that daddy he's carrying ain't gonna cut it.
Yeah, it's real thin.
But he'll be able to argue his case convincingly.
Yeah. What if he argues in front of the wrong people?
What do you mean?
Look. Confed's a much bigger machine than any of us can possibly imagine. That bastard Seether and whoever he's working with can marshal incredible resources.
Sure. Mercenaries, pirates, Confed craft, our craft.
The unmarked ships.
All without the rest of Confed even knowing about it.
And meanwhile, we come off looking like the bad guys.
You get pushed, you push back.
Giving them legitimate cause to gear up for an all-out war.
The assembly votes in 5 days.
Yeah, and they haven't got a clue as to what's really going down.
Okay, so tell me, how does our little boat fit in?
We just gotta hope that Eisen gets to the right people.
Colonel. All right, Lieutenant.
I've given Admiral Wilford a report of what occurred during the last mission, sir. He indicates that another convoy is now moving through the supply line and there are retargeting plans in the works.
The same mission, in other words.
One more time in the spam cans.
Well, you have another option, Colonel. The Admiral is launching a direct attack on the shipyard. Now, some Confed pilots have indicated they wish to defect, but they'll need cover. And the first wave from our fleet will be clearing a path. But our task would be escorting the defecting pilots back to the Intrepid.
It won't be easy telling them from the enemy.
We could use those fighters.
Colonel, the Admiral feels you're in the best position to decide which operation makes the best use of the Intrepid's resources.
Let's go for that shipyard and liberate some fighters. All right, let's move.
Colonel, we've got an urgent situation. Intelligence reports an extraordinary Confed ship in your vicinity with a top secret cargo that could be highly critical to our efforts. It's imperative that you disable and take control of this vessel. Repeat, disable. Do not destroy it. We need what's on that ship.
Sir, I'm downloading the new nav point for you, and we're sending Decker and his men in a shuttle.
We're in, boss. Keep those bogeys away from me while I do my thing. Looks like we've just bagged something very special, boss.
Mission complete.
heck is this?
None of the others have one.
Didn't go bang. Must have a separate detonator.
Real beauties, ain't they? Wouldn't even have to fly. I keep them around just to look at them.
Well, I don't think we want these to be museum pieces just yet.
No, I guess not.
What's this?
I don't know yet. Hey, get a load of this. And finally, I get to dig into something that's state of the art. Oh, don't worry, I ain't gonna cannibalize these babies. Oh. See those intakes? It's got a whole new power plant. Matter, antimatter. Just like the ones running the cap ships. You know what that means? You don't need fuel for an afterburn.
The juice comes directly from the power plant.
Exactly. Of course, that means that your guns and shields might take a little drain. But for short bursts of afterburners? Imagine the speed. Just thinking about it gives me the willies. So, kid, in your honor, I could have one of these prepped and ready in no time. Want to take one up on your next stop?
Everything the wrong side might try and shoot me down?
Yeah. That's a small price to pay for unparalleled speed and power.
What the hell, Pliers? Let's give it a go.
You got it, kid.
Colonel? Colonel, SOS message comms just came in.
If you can hear this, it might not be too late. Unmarked ships are attacking, and many people are dying. We know planet FT-957 is far from any other colony, but if you have any humanity, please send help immediately. Otherwise, our world is doomed. I don't know if this damn thing is working.
I have the Admiral.
Something terrible has apparently happened in the Telemont system, but we don't know what. Now, you're the closest ship I have to a jump point that'll take you out there. Telemont is such a frontier system that their planets have retained their original discovery numbers. But it's still part of the Border Worlds Union. All systems are equal in our eye. Now, if there's a fire to put out there, let's do it.
Plot us for Telemont. Admiral, any news of Captain Eisen?
None, I'm afraid. But I'll keep you posted if I hear anything. Well, for now.
Listen up. All right, we're going into a black hole here, people. Not the jamming kind like back on Peleus, but an informational one. FT-957 has sent out a distress signal, and we don't know why. We're going to sweep the area of hostiles and try and suss out the situation if we can.
So you're going to want to put me and my boys down on the surface, then?
Yes. I want you there, because I'll be landing, too.
What?
You people didn't see that woman's face down there. Something awful's happened, and I want to find out firsthand. I want two wingmen to escort Decker's shuttle and return here once we enter a landing pattern. All right? That's it, then. And let's be careful out there.
You got it.
Roger that.
I need two men. Get your guns. The black ships are back. Follow me. Here we go.
Hold it!
Easy. We represent the Union of Border Worlds and Vice Admiral Wilford. We're here to respond to your SOS.
That warbird ain't here for no SOS. The ones that did this to us, they were flying those.
That is a commandeered craft, you idiots. Check out this insignia.
Well, it doesn't matter anyway. You're too late.
There are only a few of us left.
It didn't take long after the bombs dropped.
Bombs? Well, this place is still standing. The airstrip's in one piece. It doesn't look like you've been touched.
The attackers didn't blow up anything, Colonel. They used bioweapons.
So no offense, Doc. How come you're still breathing?
I've been asking myself the same question. What's the pattern here? This is not random. The autopsies have been showing commonalities. Things like percentage of body fat, bone brittleness, eyesight, sperm and egg count. Everything genetically determined. What do you know about nanotechnology and bioconvergence?
Bioconvergence? Well, it's fairly new. That about covers what I know.
Well, I think the attackers dispersed replicating nanobots into the atmosphere. Billions of them.
Nanobots?
Yeah. Think of them as computers. Small as atoms. They get into your body and start a genome comparison of your DNA helix. If they don't like what they find, they start attacking your RNA. Your cells stop replicating, and they begin killing each other. Let me show you. Your body becomes a battleground. And in a matter of hours,
So how come we're not like this?
Thank your parents. The nanobots have been programmed to look for certain genetic characteristics. Low body fat, good eyesight, and so on. My guess is they can be E-proned to do anything. Any trigger in the DNA strand will do. You want to weed out the skinny folks in the world? People with iron-poor blood? You just tweak the code.
They came out of nowhere in unmarked ships. They dropped canisters like this.
How many of your people were affected?
I'd say 90%.
This is the ghost planet now, boss. I've seen this a couple times during the war. The rest of these people don't clear out soon, they'll all be committing suicide in a year or so.
Admiral Wilford will get a full report. I'm sure he'll act appropriately.
Hard to figure out what appropriate even means if you see something like this. It's a good thing that Kilrathi never figured out this stuff.
Colonel. Thank you.
I wish I could light a candle for everyone on that planet.
And fill up a space a lot bigger than this, that's for sure.
Fill up a whole planet. In all the years of the Kilrathi War, I don't think I've ever heard of anything so hideous. The pinpoint killing of the innocent. The wrong DNA strand becomes a death sentence.
It's evil. There's no other word for it.
If I'd got down to that planet with you, would I be dead too? Would anybody be lighting a candle for me?
I received a series of transmissions. Secret data on an enemy pilot. All right.
Where's Sosa?
Evan,
what are you doing?
Well, I'm
around
a pilot.
The clock.
I don't see a flight stick on this thing. This message came in a few minutes ago, and
we have a breakthrough. Recently, we've been able to link certain elements together. Perhaps we should have stumbled on this during our troubles in the Paleo system. But looking at that again, along with your position when you recently acquired those unmarked fighters, made us go back and examine other recent hotspots. Some complex triangulations have brought us to the calm at the center of the storm. And its name is Axios.
Been there, done that. Nothing in Axios.
Still an educated guess when all is said and done. But accompanying this transmission is everything we have on the Axios system. It's barren, unpopulated, desert planet. Perfect place to stage a massive force. We picked up one report of a rather large capital ship moving into the system. Good luck in your investigation.
I'm telling you, it's a wild goose chase. You want to kill some time before things get hot? Axios, here we come.
Not quite. Set our coordinates to the system closest to Axios.
Yes, sir.
We're not all going in until I see what's there. Heaving to just outside the Axios system because I don't want to risk this entire ship. Makes me nervous when it looks like no one's home. Lieutenant, what does Wilford's data tell us?
Planets are uninhabitable, so forces would be space-based, but there's a lot of comets, space debris floating through the system, so they would still have to be pretty mobile.
Well, these new fighters, can't you just go in guns blazing and take them by surprise?
And with no idea what's on the other side, that's typical Marine tactics.
For once, I agree with Hawk. We have to recon first, see what they've got.
Right, right. Now that's why I want a pair of wingmen to escort me to the jump point leading into the system. They'll peel off, and I'll go in solo. If I'm alone in one of their unmarked ships, I shouldn't attract too much attention while I snoop around.
Do you know what wartime protocol is for captured spies, Colonel?
Well, you only live once, right? All right, let's go.
Typical Marine behavior saved your flyboy butt many times.
Outside!
Need identification algorithm for clearance. Clearance to land.
the natural rulers of the universe.
Our operations in the Telemann system were a rousing success. I congratulate all who were involved. And before we close, I give you our esteemed leader.
Humanity's first line of defense. Our various enemies of the Confederation have already met with you. They know very well what you are capable of. Soon now, I will be able to reveal your existence to all the Confederation, and you will get the praise which you so richly deserve. I also wish to extol the efforts of your great commander. A fine example of what the genetic enhancement program promises for the future. The strong shall survive. A primary universal law. The species that is weak faces extinction. You know, not so very long ago, our species faced extinction. Now, the truth is, our victory over the Kilrathi was not a clear verdict of our superiority. It was a fluke, a temporary purchase of time. We will someday face an enemy far worse than the Kilrathi, and it is our duty to prepare, to remain strong, and to remain vigilant. Even if that means discarding certain elements, for separating the wheat from the chaff. Now, in the Gen Select device, we have a tool to do the job. We have tested it, and we shall use it. As you all know, the border worlds are an enemy birthing in our midst. They threaten our unity, our strength, our humanity. We all have a duty. My own is now with the Great Assembly, where I shall ratify the foundation that we have laid. When the moment comes, my fellow soldiers, you must fight, and fight hard. Thank you.
Tier 7?
Rescued only to become a prisoner. And now they're forcing me to create... I know who you are. If they find you, they'll kill you.
I got a fire waiting if we can get to it.
No, come with me. I know the way.
Incoming holotropes, Admiral.
Bad news, Admiral. There's been a security breach.
One very persistent colonel, I would expect.
The same. Always a worthy adversary.
The heart of the tiger, that's what the Kilrathi called it. Where are you now?
Requesting permission to land, sir. Colonel Blair is undoubtedly back on his ship and preparing to pursue us.
Well, the Colonel's efforts are too little, too late. I have an appointment with the Assembly and a long overdue promotion to accept. Let him try to catch us.
Gizmo I found on that ship? Well, I finally figured it out. I still find it kind of hard to believe.
At this point, Pliers, you do best to believe anything.
That baby packs a hell of a punch. You could take out a capital ship or a building, maybe even an entire installation with that thing. And what's really incredible? It does it from the inside out. Sounds crazy, don't it?
Not to me. I've seen them in action. They're called flash packs.
Well,
how many do we have?
Just the one. But I could rig up a few more in a week or so.
There's no time for that.
It's called the Vesuvius. Its maneuverability and acceleration make us look like we're standing still.
Right. I saw it when it was under construction, but I just had no idea they could get it online this fast.
It's set on the standard jump point route to the Sol system. Ship that large, there's no other option.
But a ship our size has other options. Look.
We could take a shortcut through the Elistar system and squeeze through this smaller jump point.
Which Tolwyn is never going to expect.
Because right in the middle of the system is a Confed superbase.
Exactly. Of course, invading their airspace will attract attention,
And then some. I was densely populated.
So we launch a preemptive strike. Flyers told me about that disc.
A flashback.
Thousands of civilians would be killed if you used that. The superbase isn't isolated from the rest of the system.
We have a chance to stop the war, to save millions of lives. We have to catch Tolwyn and stop him.
Agreed, but hitting them first, I say we make the superbase come after us.
Do you have any idea what kind of force they can throw at us?
Look, it's gonna be tough getting through, sure, but using the flashback deliberately causing civilian casualties, that is morally wrong.
Look, the flashback is off limits. We'll try and outrun them.
Civilian casualties are acceptable.
No, they're not.
That's enough. Now, this is going to be the hardest mission we've ever undertaken. We're going to escort the Intrepid to this jump point. That means trying to slip past the Ella superbase. And if they come after us, and I can't think of a reason why they wouldn't, it's going to take everything we've got to defeat them. Now, our only other chance is to cause civilian casualties, and that's, well, it's unacceptable. And we can do this, people. Maybe we'll just stop a war in the process. All right, let's go. See you, Captain.
Hell of a communications rig, huh? Well, we don't have time for me to fill you in on everything, so for now, let's just say that I still have a few friends at Confed HQ. The ship I'm in is the twin to the Vesuvius. And even these things have a few soft spots. Now, I'm going to dump a whole lot of data on your comm office. Some blueprints, IFF codes, the works. As you can see, certain areas of her flanks are somewhat vulnerable. Now, once these turrets are taken out, we'll see if we can't even up the fight with them.
Yes, we will, sir.
Let's go.
Thank you.
for you now, kid. I can rig this flashback gadget for you if you want. Seems like it'd be just a ticket for taking out the Vesuvius. Only thing is...
What is it?
Well, I've been studying the specs that Captain Eisen sent us.
Yeah.
That alloy they use for the skin of the supercarriers? Well, I don't know if the flashback will work on it from the outside. Seems like your best bet might be to fly inside the Vesuvius and lay the pack down in its innards. Yeah. Get a replacement for it. Yeah, firing on the inside should work.
Wow. That's what I gotta do. Load her up, guys.
Okay, come on, let's get this out of here.
Sir, we have an incoming transmission.
Well, I have to hand it to you, Colonel. Your tenacity has always impressed me. But don't think you can hide behind the shield of the surveillance any longer. She's taken far too many hits. Never should have been jumping in the first place. She wasn't really ready. You may be tenacious, but I'm the one who's invincible. You should know that by now. You won't prevent me from addressing the Assembly as Space Marshal. I think it's time to take care of the Colonel.
With pleasure.
The heart of the tiger. He's always been a thorn in my side. He could have been truly a great warrior. Now he's nothing more than a traitor.
Surprise for Admiral Tolwyn and his ship. A little bell ringer called a flashback, which I intend to deliver personally.
Good luck, Colonel. I pray you can do it.
All right, people, let's move.
Give him hell, kid. Can't wait to hear about that flashback.
Gonna raise my kill score here.
Break formation and open fire.
These guys are history. Yes! Look at him burn!
Ready to strut my stuff.
Yes! Look at him burn!
Mission complete.
Sir, we're tracking a dropship that left the Vesuvius before its successful targeting. You're cleared for refueling and rearming.
He's holding all the cards now. If we even make a move toward Earth in force, it will only lend credence to his case that the border worlds are on the warpath. I understand you got a look at Tolwyn's Black Lance operations from the inside.
Yes, sir.
The way I see it, if there's any hope of stopping this war declaration, you're going to have to head to the Assembly yourself and tell these politicians what you know. Problem is, you're a hostile in this aspect. No doubt Tolwyn is alert at Terran security. You'll face substantial automated lunar and Terran-based defenses. You got your work cut out for you, Colonel, but I have faith that you can do it.
Good luck.
Yes, you can do it.
Fight hard, Colonel. I hunger for a true challenge.
You won't see tomorrow.
Life to the protection and defense of humanity. We congratulate him on his promotion to his new post, Space Marshal Tolwyn.
Esteemed senators, thank you for bestowing this honor upon me and for allowing me to speak to you before you cast your momentous votes. Well, we can no longer ignore the obvious. The border worlds wage war against us, and we do nothing but issue decrees. We can no longer turn a blind eye. Let me lay out for you some of the more egregious transgressions that have been committed against innocent Confederation civilians. Yes, a formal declaration of war is a very terrible thing. It should not be undertaken unless all options have been exhausted. And I'm afraid to report to you that that is the case. We did not fight the Kilrathi for decades just to have an infection hollow us out from the inside. If there is a cancer amongst us, we must cut it out now. I urge you to vote yes on this declaration. Thank you.
There is a cancer that needs to be cut out.
Seize that man!
But it's not on the frontiers of the galaxy, but right here before you.
Welcome.
This is the great hero of the Kilrathi War, who has betrayed the Confederation and now fights for the union of border worlds.
I fight as I always have, on the side of peace and honor. Please, Paladin, hear me out.
If any man has earned the right to a hearing, it is Colonel Blair. Let him speak.
What price freedom, Admiral?
I come here to tell you the truth. The truth about what's really happening on the outer fringes of civilization.
Please, Colonel. You insult me as well as everyone else here. Do you really believe that this chamber is that ignorant?
I'm saying this assembly has been duped by a charade. An elaborate charade perpetrated by you, sir, who requires their ignorance in order to carry out a personal agenda. The border worlds have fallen victim to a plot, which, if allowed to proceed, will make all of humanity a victim.
Well, I suppose there is a strange logic in that. Well, please, continue, Colonel.
Do you deny, Admiral, having anything to do with the troubles on the frontier?
Only my efforts to end the troubles to maintain law and order.
Law and order. Control. Maintaining the status quo, that's what this is all about. Harmony among men is a secondary issue.
Harmony is maintained through control.
Was it harmony that made me, as a Confed pilot, party to the theft of a Border Worlds laboratory? And the outright abduction of a Border Worlds bioconvergence chemist?
How you interpret operations, Colonel, is of no consequence. Your job as a soldier is to carry out orders without question.
Without question? Have any of you questioned the Admiral about his Black Lance forces?
Marshal! What are these Black Lance forces he's referring to?
An elite force of men that I have assembled to protect our galactic interests.
And these forces are stationed at a starbase in the Axia system, isn't that right?
Well, it is my duty to station forces where they may be needed.
And the Black Lance have some extraordinary equipment at their disposal.
Effective soldiers require effective tools.
Would you qualify the GenSelect bioweapon as an effective tool, Admiral?
This assembly has never approved the development or use of a biotech weapon.
As with any experimental device, I would, of course, have brought it to your attention as soon as it neared readiness.
I think the people of Telamon know just how ready it is. The few that are left can speak of a weapon that selectively kills anyone whose physical or mental attributes don't measure up to someone's predetermined standards.
Telamon's tragedy is still under investigation. But I have no doubt it'll prove to be the doing of the Border Worlds thugs.
Yes. The skies are just full of criminals, aren't they, Admiral?
It appears so.
And hundreds of thousands of innocent lives have been lost in pursuit of these phantoms. Admiral, do you believe the strong always survive?
With every fiber of my being.
Is that why the head of the Black Lance forces is a product of the genetic enhancement program?
That program was canceled years ago.
He's more of a warrior than you will ever be, Colonel. He is excellence personified. He is
dead.
He is symbolic of all that we will achieve in the future.
What is the expense of these achievements, Admiral? The lives already lost to your Black Lance forces, the millions more who will die if this assembly votes for war? Space Marshal Tolwyn believes that our victory over the Kilrathi was a fluke, that we as a race need tinkering with, engineering. If a few billion die along the way, well, they weren't worthy anyway. Why can't we be more like the Kilrathi, addicted to conflict, the only meaning to life being found in death? Tell us all, Admiral, is that the price of freedom?
Mankind was at his zenith when fighting the Kilrathi. Now our society is crumbling. We have no goals, no focus. We've grown complacent and confused. Who will protect us when the next race tries to dominate us? Who can tell where that threat will come from and when? No, we must be prepared. Progress only comes through struggle. Fighting keeps us fit. Conflict ensures our readiness and our survival. The Kilrathi understood this. They endured for millions of years, and so shall we if we continue fighting. If we continue to perfect our methods of killing.
I think we've heard enough. The Assembly will now vote. Session.
That man has undermined everything.
Justice!
You saw the results?
Marshal Tolwyn's appeal was denied today. Tolwyn is now slated for execution tomorrow.
Instructor, not a general or a senator, and he could have had everything.
Everything means I keep flying. So if you ask me, I've got everything.
I envy you, Lenny. At times I wish I'd made the same choice myself. So how's that farm?
I'm not a farmer.
I'm talking about rolling a bomber, not a fighter. Yeah, sure, you know, rolls in training.
The all people maniac taught me one thing.
Well, hey, pal, Senator, what?
Well, you said either you're an earthworm or an eagle.
I said that?
Hey, Colonel! We got a fresh batch of newbies to shake down.
They can wait a bit. I think I'll log some flying time.
Senator,
shut up.
Yeah.
The war is over. The Kilrathi invaders obliterated by the Confederation. Now peace and prosperity rule. But the wounds of battle are slow to heal, and a frightening new enemy is born.
And now they attack us?
Fueled by the horrors of war, a deranged human mind unleashes terror upon the innocent.
You're gonna wish you never met me.
I already do.
Yesterday's heroes are summoned to fight in a battle whose victor will control the fate of mankind for centuries to come. Mark Hamill, Malcolm McDowell, and Tom Wilson embark on an epic journey that puts the destiny of all mankind in your hands. Wing Commander 4, The Price of Freedom. Get into the game. Now available on CD-ROM and Assault.
For half a century, humanity fought a battle of survival against the Kilrathi. With victory came peace and a simple life for the Confederation's greatest hero.
I'm not waiting. Don't call me honey.
Space pigs are all the same.
I guess women out here on the edge of nowhere can't appreciate a civilized man.
Sure they do. When they meet one.
Good to see you too, Colonel. Or should I say Farmer Blair?
It's a peaceful life.
I've always said you're either an earthworm or an eagle.
Red One, all clear out here.
The war is over. The Kilrathi defeated. Peace and prosperity await humanity. If only it were so simple. But the universe is not that simple. Just when you thought your flying days were over.
You are being recalled to active military service.
They pulled you back in. This time, the enemy is not an alien race, but mankind itself.
Looks like you guys ran into some trouble.
The border worlders? Barbarians, most of them.
What the devil is going on out there?
Mark Hamill.
You're gonna wish you never met me.
I already do.
Malcolm McDowell.
Let's hope that war is not our only option.
John Rhys-Davies.
A declaration of war against the border worlds has been laid before the Assembly.
Jason Bernard.
What is all of this coming to?
And Tom Wilson as Maniac.
He seems to have a hard time understanding the words no and not interested.
All return for the greatest Wing Commander adventure yet.
I bet you wish you had one of those during the war. But put the fear of God into the Kilrathi.
The battle is waged not only for control of the Confederation, but its very soul.
We should be able to think of something better to do than all this killing.
Seize that man!
You know that stunt cost us.
I don't have to tell you a damn thing.
I don't know now. Talk to me,
liar.
You got it, kid.
Am I your prisoner of war, then, Colonel?
I'm really sorry, sir.
Easy!
You son of a bitch! Shut your mouth!
Stop it!
We're sitting ducks.
Dismissed! The price of freedom is eternal vigilance.
Wing Commander 4. The fate of mankind rests with you.
Wing Commander 3 was mostly green screen, which modern audiences are so sophisticated now from watching all those making of specials on TV, as you know, or even on your local weathercasts. With a blue or a green screen, you can talk about the warm fronts coming in and put it anything you want behind when the newsreader had the pictures come behind him. In Wing 3, all of our sets were like that. So virtually everything was covered with green, and they'd pop in a slide, and you'd go look at the monitor to see exactly where you were. Here, as you can see, they've built sets, and it's on 35 millimeter film. It's closer to
a motion picture than the last one. Even though the last one, I thought, to me, I loved the challenge of the green screen, you know? I mean, instead of being intimidated by it, I just flew into it. And, I mean, I had some experience knowing what it's going to be like to be working with special effects. They couldn't get me out of the art department. I had to see every model. I had to see the drawings. I mean, I'm sure I drove everyone crazy, but they'd say, where's Mark? We need him on set. And they'd say, oh, he's up in Stuart Freeborn's office watching him make Yoda skin. But all of it fascinates me, you know? I guess acting is fun, and I do enjoy it, but I want to do a little bit of everything. I guess the union.
Maniac undergoes a lot of changes between Wing Commander 3 and Wing Commander 4. I think he's still, you know, the goofball of the story and everything. But I think that he and Blair start getting to know each other, getting to sort of have a grudging respect for each other. I mean, they're still combative, but they have to admit that, you know, they've survived. They've survived a lot together, So things move on quite nicely in Commander 4, and everybody liked the Maniac character. So, you know, I mean, Maniac's just in it more. And, you know, when you put a character in more, it can't just be this sort of one-dimensional goofball. Wing 4 and Wing 3 are very different to work on, because Wing 3, first of all, the actors kind of didn't know what they were doing. I mean, we were in a technology generally that we didn't understand. We were in a storyline that was very complex, and it was just a new thing for all of us. And the company, you know, didn't have the money in order to buy sets like this and get a real movie crew, if you want to call this a real movie crew. and do the things like that. So Wing 4, of course, is just exponentially larger in every respect, in storyline, I think, in the sets and the approach that everyone is taking to it.
And action!
I mean, I want you to, when you see Wing Commander 4, I mean, you'll have this noticeable difference between what Wing Commander 3 was like and Wing Commander 4, and you'll say, I thought Wing Commander 3 was good. This is really, I mean, I think some of the stuff we've been shooting, I'd put up next to any $30 or $40 million feature.
It's wonderful the way they've decided not to make it just another space combat. But we did that in Wing 3, so this one really stands on its own. And that's the real reason to do a sequel, is to explore new areas, not just do the same thing you did before.
Now this one, there's 38 sets. So it's really a movie. This one is a, you know, a huge movie, really, here. More than a game, even though it's going to be pulled down to a little screen on a computer. In Wing Commander 3, it always felt like there was two or three people in the spaceship. In a big spaceship, there should be thousands of people. So with the real sets, we can put a lot more people in there. We can have a sort of depth of field that you don't normally get. And just make it look richer and more lifelike and realistic.
Last year, everyone was sort of experimenting. I mean, it was one of the first, I guess, interactive game experiences like that there ever has been. So with this, I think everyone does get along better. We know each other now from the first one, and we're having a really good time.
I think probably the best reason to do this was it was such a fulfilling experience the last time.
I enjoy it. Partially because it's really fun. I'm a big hero to my son's friends. You know, it's, oh, is that your dad? And so, because they all play the game, you know. So that's always delightful. And when they meet me, he says, hi, Captain Eisen, you know.
I go to the supermarket and people go, hey, Admiral Tolwyn. I go, excuse me? I'm not in the service. You know, you forget, you know, it's such a weird thing.
Well, I'm having fun because things always change. So, like, now we're shooting on real film, we're moving the camera, we're doing real sets. And so, for me, it's still, you know, I get to learn more. And, you know, I mean, because I, you know, eventually want to, you know, direct a feature or two as well. And so, you know, as well as doing games, it's kind of like, it's another creative.
In
won't be easy telling them from the enemy.
We could use those fighters.
Colonel, the Admiral feels you're in the best position to decide which operation makes the best use of the Intrepid's resources.
Let's go for that shipyard and liberate us some fighters. All right, let's move.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Knock, knock. All right. Open the door!
If you push, we're not going to get on the train!
Stop
it! Away from the platform.
Yes,
I just need some air.
Let me up to the...
We've pulled back from the edge of this jamming black hole, sir, but well, I'd have to say we're still under partial excitement.
Oh, boy. All right. We got no choice. Go out on a search and destroy.
Hey, that's suicide. There could be a whole fleet waiting out there for us. We wouldn't know it.
No radar, no shields?
Without any guidance systems, the dumb flyers are going to be the only firecrackers worth taking.
Okay. Now something's thrown a blanket on this system. We go out, find it, and put it out of business. Move it.